much, Lois. Thanks for everybody that made this happen. Now, the reason I'm doing the introduction is not because I'm the commissioner, but because I've had the privilege of knowing John for a number of years. John's from Montrose, and a few years back, not very many, but a few years back, I gave the graduation speech. John was a senior. I nominated John here at the right. I did the nomination. Nominated John at the United States Air Force Academy. He went to the Air Force Academy, graduated from the Academy, and many tours in Iraq and
Afghanistan. Go to places too.
One of the special forces, and his primary mission was to capture a kill. Unfortunately, in the situation he was in, bring that survival. He's a real leader. He came back, still reserve, you're right now, major in the military. He's got a beautiful wife, two great kids, gets out of the military, wants to go to law school, goes to law school, calls me up after his first year, says, can you give me a job in a law firm? I said, no. He said, all you're gonna do is file papers. He said, well, I want to know a lot about energy. I said, okay, hang up, I'll call my buddies. All the jollies. I said, look, this kid's a little wet behind the ear. Get him on a rig, the lowest job possible, a rough one. And they did it. And he wanted to learn from the bottom up. He did that, graduated from, I'll let him talk a little about that, but graduated from law school. He then was one of probably several hundred, you might guess, and was selected to go to work for a firm that has about 2,000 employees or something like that. Fantastic. He had a great career there. He recently resigned. He was a state representative. He resigned that position because he wants to live his race. He's in this 100%. He'll talk to you about his values and things like that. But we've got somebody from the West Slope. We've got somebody whose credentials are unquestionable. I think you're going to feel so confident about the positions he takes on our issues that you'll find it pretty easy to support. So it's with great pleasure and honor that I introduce the next United States Senator, John Keyser. John.
Wow, Raising Family, it's so great to see you. Thanks so much for coming out. I really appreciate you taking some time, and I've met many of you virtually. How many people were at the assembly? The assembly was a lot of people, so we met over Skype. But come and say, it's nice to meet you and your family. Actually, I'll tell you a quick story about that. There was 19 assemblies that we were trying to go to that day, and of course, I grew up on Western Slope, and I said, you know what, I always feel like people on the Eastern Plains and the right in the I-25 border, they forget that we have a state that's passed the Continental Divide, and so I want to make sure we got here, and so we said, hey, we'll just we'll use Skype, and it worked. So it's nice to see you again. My name is Jon Keyser. And I am a husband, I'm a father, I'm an Air Force Academy graduate, of course, a combat veteran, I served in Iraq and Afghanistan. And I'm running to be your next United States Senator, and I'm ready to meet Michael Bennett. Are you ready to meet Michael Bennett? Oh. You know what, we can do it. 2016 is the year. It is the year. We've got to do it. You know, we've got three branches of government that we're going to be voting on. And you always hear that, hey, this is a big election coming up, the most important election. This is the most important election, okay? We've got, of course, the big, bright, shiny outfit, right? It's been the presidential election where they start with 17, and that's kind of getting figured out. Somebody will ask me about it in Q&A. I don't know who's going to win on the Republican side, but on the Senate side, we've got the most vulnerable Democrat in the country as our United States Senator, Michael Bennett, and I want to retire him. And one of the reasons why this election is so important is because, frankly, our constitutional rights hang in the balance right now. Those rights that I fought for overseas, right? When I raised my hand and swore to uphold and defend the Constitution, those rights are hanging in the balance with the unfortunate passing of Justice Scalia. And we've got to make sure that we elect a Republican Senate majority so that we can make sure that we replace Justice Scalia with a Supreme Court justice who's in that same vein, who's the originalist, who understands the Constitution and doesn't make law from the bench. And I think that's so important. We got a United States Senator right now, Michael Bennett, who I'll talk a little bit about in my campaign. I'm going to just remind you of a few things that he's done since he's been our United States Senator, and give you my vision for it, where we can change. You know, my campaign's about national security and economic security, because I don't think you can have one without the other. I think they go hand in hand. And Michael Bennett voted to give the world's largest state sponsor of terrorism $150 billion. He voted to give them a clear path to a nuclear weapon by the time my kids, Jack and Eleanor, will be in junior high school. He also voted at a time, frankly, when our energy economy here on Western Slope is struggling. He voted to allow Iran to put an additional 1 million barrels of oil per day on the global oil markets, and they're sending that oil right now to our friends in Europe. Frankly, Michael Bennett has done more for the economy in Iran than he has for us here in Colorado. I think that's wrong. You know, let's talk about Guantanamo Bay really quick. It's something that I know quite a bit about. I continue to serve in the Air Force. I'm an intelligence officer, career intelligence officer. I had a top secret security clearance my entire adult life. And right now I'm assigned, when I made major, they took me a couple years ago down to Southern Command, so Central and South America. Part of what we are in charge of there is Guantanamo Bay, the guys who are in Guantanamo Bay. You know, we started with about 650 people in Guantanamo Bay. The people who were there, by the way, they weren't street criminals. Okay? These are the world's most dangerous terrorists. And Michael Bennett has voted a number of times, now three times, to support the president's plan to close Guantanamo Bay, and they want to bring the world's most dangerous terrorists out of Guantanamo Bay and import them into the United States. And of course, we know the recent report came out and said the top of the list is Colorado. They want to bring the world's most dangerous terrorists to Colorado. Now, let me tell you what, if I'm your next United States Senator, Guantanamo Bay will be open for business, and business will be booming. You know, you ask a guy like Michael Bennett, and he said this, he actually brought this up in D.C. here recently. He said, you know, the biggest threat to our national security is global warming. Let me tell you what, folks, I've been to war twice. Global warming is not our biggest threat. YouTube era, but YouTube's interesting because all that stuff that politicians say, it all gets recorded, it's all online. And the other day somebody sent me a link and they said, hey, you gotta watch this, this is pretty important. So I watched it, turned on, and there's Michael Bennett standing up on stage, and I think he was in Grand Junction, actually, in Two Rivers. And he said, you know, we really gotta do something about our national debt. He said, we really gotta do something about it. And you know what he did? He did something about it, he doubled it. The time that he's been in the United States Senate, he's doubled our national debt. Now, to me, that's a moral issue. Because I look at my two kids, and my son is 7 months old, and he already owes, as his portion of our national debt, he already owes $65,000 as his portion of debt. That's every man, woman, child, all of your kids, all of your grandkids. Everyone owes $65,000 of their share of the debt. We have a spending problem in Washington, D.C. We've got to send proven fiscal conservatives back to Washington, D.C. in order to fix it. And you know what, I am a proven fiscal conservative, because when I was in the House of Representatives, I represented swing county, obviously Jefferson County is a swing county. My district had more unaffiliated voters than Democrats or Republicans, very similar to our state, which has the same. You know, but I was a fiscal conservative, and I stood up when the governor last year proposed the largest budget power in history, the largest spending increase in Colorado history. I fought against it. And you know what I had to do? I had to fight against not only just Democrats, but frankly also big spending Republicans. And that's exactly what we've got to do, because we have to admit that we didn't get to $19 trillion just with Democrats. We got to $19 trillion with Democrats and Republicans. And we need to have fiscal conservatives that are going to get our house in order. And I will do that as your next United States Senator. So this is our sixth stop today. It's been we ended our night in Colorado Springs late at 11:30 or so. Got up about 4 in the morning, and you know, and along the way here, I was talking to a doctor, and the doctor was telling me that you know, the biggest thing that has been destroying the medical practice right now is Obamacare. you know, it's physicians that are just leaving. They're just leaving altogether. They're saying, you know what, I can't deal with the regulation anymore. I can't deal with all the bureaucracy that has overcome my ability to see my patients. And that's been because of Obamacare. There's also a small business owner that I spoke to today. He owns a restaurant. He owns a restaurant in Avon. And he said, you know what, we've always provided health care to my employees, but since Obamacare has happened, we can no longer afford it. We can't do it. So now they cut that as a benefit. They don't give that to their employees anymore. You know, healthcare was broken before Obamacare. But let's remember how we got to where we are right now. In order to pass Obamacare, they needed 60 votes in the Senate. Michael Bennett voted for Obamacare. They had exactly 60 votes. If he would not have voted for Obamacare, we would not have it today. And you know what? We need to repeal it. We need to replace it. And I will do that when I'm in the United States Senate. One last thing here before we take questions, because I certainly want to know what's on your mind. You know, when I was, I did grow up on the western slope here, and wouldn't it be nice to have a senator that that knows that Colorado is a lot bigger than just the distance of I-70? Yeah. So I came from a blue-collar family. My dad was a construction worker. And you know, so really, my childhood was really shaped a lot by our energy industry here in Colorado. And when I talk about energy, having spent so much time in the Middle East, I know that energy security is national security. It's an easy thing. It's a very easy equation, and you know, it's something that I know a lot about because when my dad was a construction worker, we went to the Four Corners area because there was a lot of construction jobs. With Amoco down there and the shale boom and everything that was going on, it's something that affected me certainly from an early age, but later I went on and learned more about the oil and gas industry as a rougher, and worked in the peons. And by the way, still have all my fingers and toes, and I'm pretty proud of it. You know, we have got to be able to get the regulators off the backs of employers in this country. And frankly, you know, Michael Bennett does not understand, and he doesn't respect the fact that the decisions that get made in Washington, D.C., they have a real effect on us right here on the Western Slope. I know that the decisions that get made in D.C. do affect everybody in our state. Of course, they affect us here on the Western Slope. We need jobs. Those are very, very good jobs. They employ so many people, not just me in the oil and gas industry, but all the other surroundings, the service industries, the construction industry, the winery here, right? I mean, we're talking about tourism, we're talking about construction, restaurants, all these different things. We have got to get our energy economy moving again in the United States. And I know that we can do it. We can do it, but it's going to take a change because you've got guys like Michael Bennett who have a different philosophy than most of us. You know, they actually have a new, it's no longer about, oh, we want clean air, clean water. We all want clean air and clean water, right? That's not, what they've decided now is that they have a new theme. It's keep it in the ground. That's their new theme. Just keep it in the ground. They're actually saying that as their new tagline. You know what? We need to develop our natural resources that are God-given, that we own, and we need to open that up on federal lands as well. Make sure that we have access to our federal lands, get the BLM off our backs, and make sure that 75% of our land that's here in Mesa County that's controlled by the federal government that goes back to the control of those of us that live in Colorado, that live in this area. So these are issues that I understand because I grew up here. You know, and I think you can read a lot, you can get a lot of briefings from policy people and things like that, but until you really live something, you really can't understand it too well. So I do understand these issues, and I will be your advocate, and you're the best senator that we've ever had here from Colorado on the Western Slope. And you know, I just want to end with this before we take questions. As we put thousands of miles on our truck, 8,000 I think so far since we kicked off the campaign. Big state. As we've been around, you know, it's every city that we stop in, people are angry. People are upset, very upset. And I share that anger and I share that frustration. Because they're mad at guys like Michael Bennett, who are the Washington, D.C. establishment. Because they go to Washington, D.C., and all they care about is going along and getting along. They don't even care what happens back here in Colorado. You know, Michael Bennett is a third-generation Washington politician. He's a third generation. He grew up in Washington, D.C. His dad's from there, his grandfather. You know, so I don't know what we expect. He's a third-generation Washington politician with three silver spoons in his mouth. You know what? But I've got a Bronze Star medal, and I will be here in November, and I need your help. So thank you.